make it a more feasible process, and so that the instead of being so focusing so entirely on technology, they their partner education, their partner organizations can be actually be the grassroots level organizations that Givology wishes to.
Okay, and we also wanted to design, so assessing the feasibility of the project and designing a measure of success that has to be kind of catered, I guess, to partnerships that is created actually. So to identifying the right projects, really this is like to assess fit with the mission statement, assess the feasibility of the project, design a measure of success. These are really essential components that we think would actually help maybe formulate what the application criteria would be for the project partners. One major obstacle that we kind of identified here is that Givology writes a check after it's funded, after it's raised the fund for the project or for the student. And I feel like time is actually a problem, maybe, because if the donors choose who to donate to, and one student can fund it very quickly, but what if another student's wait like half a year or a year? Time is very important in education. So just our final topic is on logistics three, so targeting donor groups actually for expansion. We believe that currently Givology targets a lot of college students at the moment. It's kind of college-based, but it's limiting itself to the college community. And we feel like it could expand both on a micro local level and then a macro level as well. So we feel like not limited to the donor base, and then issue challenges to the donors. Okay, so one thing that immediately Givology might be able to do is really integrate the audience, or I mean, the donors, into really partaking into these things. Not all donors really, I did a little survey today and asked like 20 people if they gave, would they be really interested, gave to Givology, would they be really interested in learning more about the feedback from the students, and some college students really did care. Some of the more professors would care. They would get those feedback, but it really, the donor level needs to be catered, I guess. And then promote successes. Givology should, I feel like the depth aspect of it, maybe Givology should be target to project-based or student-based, so fund each project completely before starting another project. That way you don't have this lag, which is one thing we really recommend. So our overall proposal simplified. So consolidate a solid mission, identify smaller and achievable goals, and the mission statement to further focus the direction Givology will take. So, and then identify a unique trademark to distinguish Givology, which we actually think that since it's a microfinance organization, a little goes a long way. And this should be really pushed towards the donors, because a lot of donors kind of have this misconception that you need to donate, you need to donate a lot. And then target. So narrow the number of projects, but do not limit donor base, and consolidate them.
I'm
going
to have to
cut
you off now. Okay.
Well, you're finished, so two premises that you're sort of basing your analysis on are that one, Givology's mission is to maximize social impact. And then the second premise is that, you know, they need a trademark that sort of shows how they're unique. I would like to challenge that, because I think the first assumption about maximizing social impact, their model is very individualized, again, as we mentioned before, and so it's very hard to maximize, let's say, number of children or something like that. So maybe it's more than quality of the relationships rather than maximizing. So I was just wondering how you kind of reconcile that.
When we mentioned social impact, we didn't mean like quantitatively. When we said maximize social impact, given their the model that they already have, we meant that to be able to affect, to create as much social impact as possible, whether this be quantitatively or qualitatively, by further enhancing the actual web of communication between the donors and the students.
And then the second point around the trademark, I actually felt like one of the most compelling things about Givology is that it does have such a unique trademark. So I was just curious about, you know, whether you had concerns about its current trademark.
Yeah, actually, regarding that, it's just like, I don't think it's emphasized as much as it should be. Givology's trademark does have, I mean, they do have a trademark, but I feel like they could explain them a little bit more or apply it more in practice, I think, is what I was kind of going for. Because really, it's a microfinancing organization. It takes a dollar, just tries to stretch it as much as possible. And maybe that principle can be applied to like how donors can start, donors on the local level can start donating. Because I mean, if everyone gave a dollar in a classroom, and you have several classrooms in a high school or a college, then this is really actually putting the principle into applying a little is to a lot, I guess.
Just to follow up on that, and maybe I can help you clarify. It's all about messaging, just having
yes.
a very clear message, like micro scholarships or something. Yes. Like a nice catchphrase.
Yeah.
I thought you identified a very real problem in the nonprofit sector, or not problem, but a very real issue, which is not all donors want to hear about. They just want to give the money and feel good and say, I give money. Now, being that Givology prides itself in that feedback and that communication, how do you propose they approach those donors who just want to give money and
I feel like there should be a general fund, and at the same time, like, get that information if they do want to. I mean, I think you should accept any donations as possible, but if you want to continue a sustainable relationship with the donor, then maybe at the end of the year, send them a kind of newsletter, I guess, on what has currently been done, and then maybe ask them to subscribe another amount for that year. And maybe that one-time thing is a lot less bothering for some people than ask them to pledge, because we went on the website and a lot of people have pledged $0. But like it's the difference between actually acting on the pledge and making it so that people do care. And I mean, there are people who care and you want to sustain that relationship, but you can garner more donations, I guess, from the people who don't.
Another way that you mentioned was like by consolidating the internal framework more, so by actually like if they have high school chapters, and their high school chapters reach out to like middle schools and elementary schools, and by actually creating like challenges, and like in say in a classroom, if each child donates like a dollar, right? And the teachers in the classroom, like let's say the teacher is the main donor, and each child gives their like the pool of funds of the classroom goes to the teacher, and the teacher gives it to Givology. That entire classroom has a vested interest in the project that they're financing, you know. So they would much by creating this framework, we make sure that it's not just individuals that are donating, but there's like a bigger, broader vested interest in actually wanting to set up this communication between the donors and the class and the students themselves.
So that'll be time now, but thank you.